have to take this to another level. We have to dance. Sitting Bull, who, as you know, beat General Custer and was that archetypal plains warrior, was also a shaman. And so he said, okay guys, the shamans have talked, we dance. And some of the braves wouldn't do it, but most of them did. And the last ghost dance was at Wounded Knee. That's what Wounded Knee was. It was a ghost dance. And they tried to say to the military, look, this is a peace dance, you know. And they even had a guy called Wovoka, who I feel very close to, who said to the Indian agencies, look, I'm a missionary, I'm a priest. And we're really with you on this Jesus thing, you know. Peace, love, that's what we're about, really. And this dance is a peace dance. But they didn't trust them. And they surrounded the dance with cannon and machine guns. And at some point, something triggered. And they massacred everybody, men, women, children. What was happening? What was the ghost dance? How do you take it to another level? The shamans are now telling us, 2012, big stuff coming down. Now I'm just repeating what they've told me. I have been shown things, I've seen visions, so what? But for me, it's already there. The beginning of this year, if you were living in Russia when the fires were there, if you were living in Pakistan, if you were living in Mobile, the American town that got completely wiped out by tornadoes, if you were living in Fukushima, your world would already have ended. You would already be in the end time. It's happening. So what is it? What is this end time? A lot of people talk about the survival elements. That's not what we're about. We're all going to die anyway. How cool is it if we go together? You know, it's like, what's the big deal? But this is not about death, and it's not about survival. It's about the quality of consciousness. What the ghost dance, those Native Americans were dancing for, was they were saying, actually, what's at stake here is not our community, but humanity, consciousness itself. These guys have lost the plot. They're not conscious. We have to embed in the other world, the sub-quantum reality. We've got to embed what it is to be a human being, and we've got to do it really strong, because these guys are taking over. So they had to dream it, and the ghost dance is a dream dance, and that's why it took 4 days and some people died. They're working all the time with the rhythm, with the kundalini, and they're bringing it up here. And then they dream. And that dream was that at some point in the future, the true human being would manifest in the children of the soldiers that we're facing. They will come to know and respect the ways of the red man. That time is here and now, and you will know it. You can see the teepees. Native American teachings are everywhere, and we honor them. So that time is now. This is the end time. And some of those shamans said, and we're coming back to help with this. And the Mayans are back here. All the shamans are back. All the yogis are back. Every conscious being who's trying to raise consciousness is back at this time to raise consciousness. For what? So I just give you my theory, but it's drawn and born here in Sunrise from sitting with Hugh and Jeff Stray and Mark Healy and getting to understand, and the astrologers, and getting to understand exactly what 2012 is about. 2012 is about the rising sun at winter solstice conjuncting galactic center. It hasn't done that for 26,000 years. It's only an angle, but in astrology, it's a symbol. What it's a symbol for is that at that point, galactic center, 27 Sagittarius, there is a portal. And humanity has had 26,000 years to evolve something. What is it? It's not these microphones. It's not the technology, the energy systems. It's consciousness itself. What aspect of consciousness? The quality of the heart, creativity, music, that is consciousness itself. And that is what we have to do, what the Native Americans did. We've got to take all of that that we have as the new indigenous peoples onto that dream level. Then it doesn't matter what happens here. We might lose everything, but we will have done our work, and that consciousness will be residing in the Mayan, and maybe we'll get a chance over the weekend to talk about this. But talking with Jeff and John Major Jenkins, who was recently in Glastonbury, the Mayan tablets talk about the return of the great Jaguar King. To an archaeologist, that means that this dude who in 600 AD was called the Jaguar King thinks he's going to reincarnate and come back in 2012. And that's what the whole tablet is about. They're not reading it shamanically. Why would the top priest king in the Mayan culture, fantastic culture surrounded by jungle, why did they have their chief deity a jaguar and a black one? Why? It's a predator. But for them, it was the ultimate deity. They called it the Eater of Souls. In the tablets, they talk about the return, not of some jaguar king, the return of the ultimate predator, the ultimate eater of souls. And they did special dances with black jaguar skins. We've been doing special dances to the black jaguar since 2004 without understanding why. I only learnt this last year. In Native American culture, the black jaguar is the power, the animal power, to lend you the courage to enter the void. That's beyond form. To go there on a shamanic level, you have to be rooted in your eternal spirit, because everything else disappears. Yet your point of consciousness remains, and you are one with everything. There's no difference. So we have to take that level of consciousness. And another element of the tablet said, this will be the time of the harvest of the white flower souls. So I've been thinking, what is that? And talking with people from Mayan country and shamans and dancers, they say the white flower souls are you guys. We are the white flower souls. We are the ones who are working constantly to raise the consciousness of humanity. It doesn't matter how you do it. You teach yoga, you teach dance, you're a musician. You're here because you want to raise the vibration. This is a human story and you want it to be as good as it gets. That's the job. That's our job. And the harvest is the energy that we create from that work. And she, the cosmic mother, the great black jaguar in the sky, is going to come and take it. Now, on a cosmic physics level, she can do that with a massive galactic kundalini wave that we're dust. That can happen anytime. Call it a supernova, it doesn't matter what you call it. She is quite capable of turning us to dust in an instant tomorrow. But this still lives. And so if she wants this, and she wants to take it and birth it in some other part of the galaxy in a whole new way, that's her business. It's not ours. Ours is to do the best we can. If she births it here again, that's her business. What's the lifespan of a human soul? You all thought it was eternal, right? Maybe not. Maybe like every other thing that's ever lived, it has a birth, a life, and a death. Maybe 2012 is, come in, your number is up. And maybe not, I don't know. But it could be. It doesn't matter. Because the one thing I am certain of is we're going to be dancing. And we're going to have done the work. And we've got 18 months. We're going to be as juicy as we can possibly get. And we're going to give it all back to her. So that's the ghost dance. Don't listen to Mr. Gore. Yes, we have to do stuff about energy and all of that. And I can talk to you about that. But the real stuff, the real work, is actually what we're doing here in Sunrise. So enjoy. Oh.